This is Ann, age 8. This is Amy Dawn, age 6. This is Christopher, age 8. This is Jenny, age 7. These children and others like them will try to make you understand what they're talking about on Child's Play. And here is the host of Child's Play, Bill Cullen.
Hello there, thank you. Thank you kindly. That's all right. Oh, thank you, and welcome to Child's Play, a game for grown-ups. Well, we come to more or less of a milestone at this moment because we have our returning champ returning for this, which will be her final day because we have a limit of 5 appearances. And here she sits, ladies and gentlemen. Within 3 months and a few days, she will become a brand-new mother. But more, well, not more importantly than that, no. But also quite important is the fact that in the past 4 days, she has become $12,900 the richer, Karen Keene. Welcome back, Karen.
Thank you very much.
Boy. Oh, isn't that nice? All that money for your very own. Tell us a little bit something about you, because this will be your last chance.
Well, I was a member of the 1976 rowing Olympic team.
Uh-huh.
And now I run to keep fit, and I have a small calligraphy business.
Uh-huh. Calligraphy is a very interesting art. It is the art, is it not, of printing and writing and script,
yes,
and things like,
mm-hmm,
that. And we want to welcome your opponent right now. He's a husky fella. It's a good thing it's not a physical battle. His name is Jeff Gale. Welcome, Jeff. Good to have you.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about you, Jeff.
All righty. I'm married, live in Glendale. I'm in real estate. When I'm not doing real estate, I recreate horse races on the radio. In other words, we recreate them as they were run earlier that day for the benefit of the people that never went out to the racetrack.
Hey, that's a pretty good idea. You do that professionally, huh?
Well, we try to think we are.
Well, okay, I'm sure you are.
Yeah.
You know how our game. I do the same thing here. I recreate what happened 1,000 years ago in a dream. If you're all set, let's get to play Child's Play. We aimed our cameras at kids who are 5 to 9, and we asked them to interpret some everyday words for us. Now, your job, of course, will be, as usual, to guess what those words are. Start the guessing, as we always do, with our champion. That's Karen. So you get first guess. Now, first of all, let's show the people at home the word you're both going to be playing for. Okay, word is up there. And here comes lovely Jenny Lieb. Jenny is 8 years old, and she's about to describe this word. Jenny?
I hate them. Well, they're things when you have to work. Like, say, well, I get my allowance when I do them. And if I don't, then bye-bye allowance. Well, they're usually like making your bed or doing the dishes or something like that. But I hate them. Yucky.
Yucky, she said. That was Jenny Lieb. And based on Jenny's description, what do you think we're looking for, Karen?
I hate them too. Chores.
Chores is the right answer. It's one for you. I sort of hate him, too, now that you mention that. Okay, you're going to start this one, Jeff, so you watch carefully. First, for the folks at home, here comes the word. That's what we're looking for. I love this name. He is Damien Pierre. And Damien Pierre is 6 years old, and here's his description of this word, Damien.
It's like if there's a dragon in your way, and you was a prince, like, and you kill the dragon with a sword stuff. And the dragon died. And a princess was there and you killed the dragon. The king would say, "You're a very nice boy." And maybe he would say that you may marry my daughter or something.
Okay, Damien, that's Damien's description, Jeff. Now think it over. What one word comes to your mind after listening to Damien Pierre?
If I was slaying a dragon, I'd be a knight.
Knight is a good answer, but it's not what we were looking for. Now, we have that bit of information, and Karen's going to get a chance to listen to, is it a brother? A sister team, is it not? They are Marissa and Joanna Capozzo. Marissa and Joanna Capozzo, they're both 6 years old. so I would have to assume that they are twins. Oh, brilliant, Bill, brilliant. I haven't been doing this work for all these years for nothing. So listen to the Kaposa kids as they describe the same word. Ladies?
It's like on Halloween when there's a haunted house and you're scared and you have to go in and you say, all right, I'll come in. And like when a gorilla chases you and they put you in a cage.
She took all my answers. She took the words right out of my mouth.
Thank you. Thank you, other one. No, that's the Kaposas or the Dolly sisters. But based on that, what do you think we're looking for, Karen?
Well, if you had to go in a haunted house and you were scared, but you went in anyway, I'd say you were brave.
Brave is the answer. The land of the and the home of the. 2-4, Karen. Jeff has not scored yet, so we play Child's Play until time is up. Whoever is ahead at that point wins $500 and a chance at $5,000. We'll be back with more Child's Play right after this.
Weekdays are great days for great action.
He's having a great time with you, Dave. We're going to have a great contest.
Great excitement.
Isn't that great?
It looks great.
You get great answers.
I've been great. I'm thrilled to be here.
Great fun.
All-time great.
Great matchups.
Great.
Great.
Great. Great. Great.
It's a great way to spend the day.
Isn't that a great deal?
Great. Great.
Greater.
Greatest.
Very nice indeed.
We're having a great time.
Daytime Buzz. It's great. Today, starting at 10, only on BUZZR. Let's play.
Get set with a new word. This time we're going to begin with you, Karen, and we're going to show the folks at home, as we usually do, the word you're both playing for. The word is up there, and here's Tanya Powers. Tanya is 6 years old. She describes the word. Tanya, dear.
You can feel like you don't feel well, and you cough and sneeze a lot, and you have sniffles, and you can't go to school, and you cough and sneeze a lot, and you have to stay at your house. And your mother has to give you medicine to make you feel better.
I can't tell you what I'm laughing at. All I will say is, what word comes to mind, Karen?
If you cough and sneeze a lot, you might have a cold.
No?
I guess not.
Keep that description in mind, all of you, because it's going to get more interesting as a little more is revealed. Jeff, keep that in mind and listen to Michelle Holcomb. Michelle's from Kentucky, and she's 8.5 years old. Now, remember, she's describing the same word. Michelle?
I went to my friend's house at my grandma's, and I spent the night with her, and we went to bed and everything, and I wasn't used to her house, and so I got up and I started to cry, and she woke up and she said, well, what's wrong? And I said, I need to go back to my grandma's house. And she says, well, call your grandma's house. So I called my grandma, and she said, well, what's wrong? I said, I'm not used to her house yet.
Okay, now, based on what you heard, Jeff, what word do you think we're looking for?
Well, being all that sick, could she have allergies?
No. No? This gets more amusing. Nothing against, no reflection against either of our players. I just will take this moment to say, remember, these are children describing these words. It's your turn, Karen. And here's an 8-year-old, Heidi Lucas, with the final description of this word. Heidi?
Like, you go away to camp, and you really miss your family. Sometimes you cry, and you really, really miss them, and you want to see them. And then when they come and see you, you don't miss them anymore. And then they go back, and then you get it again.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Yeah. Well, did that little proverbial light bulb light up? I think it did on both your heads. Karen, it's your turn. What's the word?
It's kind of like having a cold, but it's homesick.
Homesick is the answer.
Oh, shoot.
It's 3-9. I love the description. The word was homesick, and Tanya Power says when you feel or you don't feel good and you cough and sneeze and you stay home, you're homesick. Makes perfect sense to me. We have a 3-0 game. We have another we have another word coming up, and let's show it to the folks at home. Sure, you're homesick. Okay. Now, everybody knows what this is, but our players, Juliana Stefanoff, who's 7.5 years old, gives you an excellent description. Jeff, watch carefully.
It's a place where people go, like Frank Sinatra, Marilyn Monroe, and there are like lots of shows there. And you go there because you're going to be a big movie star. Lots of movie stars go there, like Farrah Fawcett, Brooke Shields, Christopher Atkins, all those, mush mush. Some people go to those casinos they have there with jackpots, which I like those things. And like you just press like one of those things and then all the money comes out. If you get three the same kind, like three apples, you get money.
Thank you, Juliana, for well, now. All right, Jeff, what do you think the word is?
I love jackpots, too. Las Vegas.
Oh. No. Joe, nothing against you. I just had a feeling that was going to happen. Okay, we have the same word being... That's worse than homesick. We have the same word being described by, oh, here she is, our friend and little actress. She seems like one. Katie Pulley, 9 years old. Katie, dear, please.
Well, Bing Crosby sang something like... Out where they say, let us be gay, I'm going, And, well, it's a city kind of near Los Angeles. It's a very nice town. And hooray for, Well, and there's also a song about it, and... And it's a great town.
Okay, now, based on that, I say these are children doing the description. What do you think it is?
Hollywood.
Hollywood is the right answer. I don't know how we got that. It was a perfect description preceding that. Then all of a sudden we got the jackpot. And we found out since then that jackpot is homesick. It's 4-0. When we come back to Child's Play, we're going to shift gears, play it for Fast Play. We'll be back with Fast Play. It's just a...
Take a look at this beautiful convertible.
A brand new car.
Vintage reeling and dealing never goes out of style.
That's yours. That car. Yours.
Let's make a deal. Tonight at 8 on BUZZR. Let's play.
So now time for Fast Play. This is going to give you a chance to catch up, Jeff, because it can be done here. We're going to show both of you a series of children. Each child will be defining a different word. The moment you think you know what the word they're talking about is, hit that button. We'll stop everything, give you an opportunity to answer. In Fast Play, we double the points. So from now on, each right answer is worth 2 points. When you hear the school bell, time is up. Whoever is ahead at that point wins $500 and a chance at $5,000. Okay, 4 for Karen and Jeff has nothing. Get ready to interrupt. First word, Jennifer Detlefson has it. Jennifer.
Somebody who rides a horse and they wear all different color uniforms.
Karen's first.
Jockey.
Karen's right. You pick up 2 points and lead 6-0. Okay, remember, Jeff, the minute you think you know. Next word, Tim McAndrews. Tim.
You use it when you try and get all the wrinkles out of clothes.
That's Jeff.
An iron.
That's right, Jeff. You pick up 2 at 6-2. Here's the next word, and Lena Tate describes it. Lena.
It's some place where you work out, like if you're going to be in a fight, some...
And that's Karen.
Jim.
Jim is the right answer. You pick up another 2, 8-2's the score. Here comes Nicholas Dom with the next one. Nicholas.
It's a thing you throw
throw. It's round like a disc.
Karen again?
Frisbee.
Right again. 10-2. Next word brought to us by Rand Waldron. Rand.
It's a grape that it's been.
Karen.
Raisin.
Raisin is right. You took a chance, but it was a good chance. Laura Gordon has the next one.
Many people write legends about them, and they might be magic, and they work in the mine.
It's Karen again.
Leprechauns?
Nope. Now you get the entire balance of the description of your very own, so listen carefully, Jeff, and Laura, pick it up, please.
And every night they come home, and they live in these little houses with little beds, and they wear these hats. And some of the names are like Sleepy, Dopey, Happy, Smiley.
Jeff?
Seven Dwarves.
Okay, Dwarf is what we were looking for, as you described it, Jeff. Scores, 12-4. Well, get ready, both of you. Here's a short one with Sasha Segan.
This large city is the capital of Russia.
Karen.
Moscow.
Moscow, of course. You lead the game 14-4. Here's another one, Joshua Prinsky. Joshua.
Like a sea snake.
Jeff.
Eel.
Eel's right, Jeff. You pick up another two. It's 14-6. Here's the next one. April Armstrong has it. April.
It's something where you go to learn. And
Jeff.
School.
Right, Jeff. You pick up another eight, another two, 14-8. Cynthia Hendricks. Cynthia.
It's when it's somebody else's, and you ask them if you.
Yes, Karen.
Borrow.
Borrow, right answer. Score, 16-8. That's it. Time's up. You've done it again, Karen. Come on over here. You're the winner. Slow. Slow there, Mother. Well, you're good. You do a very good job. And you played against a marvelous opponent, a very good opponent. Jeff Gale, may I say thank you. You ran up against a lady who was really on a hot streak, doing very well. We had some very nice gifts for you. Thanks for being with us on Job
Thank
Play.
You. I had a lot thank of fun. You,
Jeff. Well, look at you. You did it. Five consecutive days, and now you're going to have a chance at picking up some more money. You just picked up another five, and we'll give you a shot at another $5,000 in our triple play game. We'll be back right after this for you.
What do we have back there for Donna? A beautiful living room set. It's a beautiful, elegant dining room set.
Beautiful modern furniture.
What do we have behind that curtain?
A new dining room set.
Beautiful patio furniture. Open up the curtain and show her what's back there. You have a beautiful living room set.
Let's make a deal. Furnishing the fun. Tonight at 8 on BUZZR. Let's play.
Well, Karen, we haven't had too many five-time winners, but here you are back for your fifth and final day. Picked up another five, which brings you to $13,400. Now you're shot at triple play and a chance at another $5,000. Now, we asked our Child's Play kids to write brief definitions of simple words, and we took three definitions per word. I know you know this. Each written by a different child, A, B, or C. You have a total of 45 seconds to get six words. We pay $100 a word. Get them all, you win $5,000. But as of this very moment, on your final appearance here, you're standing at 13,004. Okay, now bring in the clock. And the clock, as you know, will not start until you tell me where you're going to start. Good luck. I hope you do it.
B.
Water where ducks and fish can swim.
Pond. C.
A hole in the ground filled with fish, plants, and water.
Lake. A.
It is something like a tornado, but it's usually larger.
Hurricane.
Correct.
B.
It's like taxes. It goes up.
Inflation.
Correct.
C.
The real thing made by the original maker.
B.
This is something that is not a fake.
A.
Something that is not made of plastic.
Real. Next word.
Go.
B.
A place where there are pipes, soil, and water.
C.
Below the earth.
Underground.
Correct.
A.
Gold, bronze, or silver medal.
Award. B.
Award is the right answer.
B.
This is a person that is company to you.
C.
When you have a friend. Oh. When you have a friend or relative over, Any idea? Well, it would be anticlimactic at this point anyway. That last one was guest. Guest. And the one you missed up in there, this is something that is not a fake, and something's not made of plastic, and real, genuine.
Oh.
Genuine. However, that's sort of, you know, beating a dead horse. The nice part about it is you pick up an additional $500. Your total winnings right now, Karen, you take with you our compliments and $13,900. Oh. Thank you. We'll be back in just...
Up next, using your body to form phrases can be hazardous, but a lot of fun on Body Language. Then it's Alphabet Soup on TV with Blockbusters. Stay tuned.
Karen Keene, $13,900. You played well.
Thank you.
You have any plans for the money?
Not really, except that we do have the baby coming, so.
That will take care of 13-9 quickly.
Uh-huh.
Thank you all ever so much. If you like kids, you'll love Child's Play. Goodbye, we'll see you.
Some departing contestants receive Be Everything You Can Be with Mary Kay Cosmetics. Skincare and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your own home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics. A cassette recorder. This GE portable AC-DC cassette recorder has an automatic shutoff. AC adapter included. Great to take with you any place. A cookbook and super clip holds what you want when you want it. Self-adhesive or screw-in. The household organizer in the Triad package super clip. Bed Sacks provides luxury upholstery for your old mattresses or box springs and protection for new from Bed Sacks. And all of the children appearing on Child's Play this week receive MGA Mitsubishi 12-inch portable black and white television with UHF tuning to channel 83. Built-in antenna, lightweight with increased brightness and contrast controls and earphone jack, MGA Mitsubishi. Or Yamaha HS500, a 25-note portable keyboard with 5 electronic musical games. Features 5 different instrument sounds. Learn music the fun way with a handy sound from Yamaha. And some of the schools providing production facilities will receive K-Pro. The latest concept in personal home computers, 64K capacity, CRT and double disc drives, weighs 26 pounds. Complete software package, home education and adventure games, K-Pro. This is Gene Woods speaking for Child's Play. I'm Mark Goodson, television production.